Hey folks, it's me, Michael Bach, your diversity dude, and this is Monday Morning Musings. Happy Monday. I hope this finds you well, safe, and healthy. I am back after a couple weeks of much-needed vacation, which I'm going to talk about next week. But I made the unfortunate decision, which I regretted immediately, of shaving my face. I hadn't shaved in 15 years, and I decided I would see what was under that that scruff. And I don't even know what I look like. But feel free to share comments down below as to what I look like. That'll be fun. Don't worry, I'm growing it back as quickly as I can. If you're new to my channel, welcome. Thanks so much for taking some time to watch. Please do remember to subscribe by clicking on the link, which is somewhere around me, to find out whenever I release a video, which is every Monday, except when I forget and it's on Tuesdays, or sometimes when I'm on vacation. I don't, you get it. It's sometimes on Monday. That's the whole idea. I wanted to very briefly talk about what happened last week in Atlanta, Georgia, with the brutal murder of 8 individuals who were specifically targeted because they were East and Southeast Asian. And overall, the significant uptick that we have seen in anti-Asian racism, and not just in the United States, but here in Canada over the past year. This has been inflated by the now former president, who still refuses to call the COVID-19 virus by its true name and calls it the China virus or the Kung flu, just a vile human being. And it's encouraged racism. And I think we all need to take a big step back. The name of a virus doesn't tell us anything. We call it the Spanish flu of 1918. If you're not familiar, the Spanish flu was the last great pandemic, but it didn't start in Spain. It actually started in Kansas, but it's never referred to as the Kansas flu. We tend to scapegoat, and we fall into our old patterns of racist behavior. This virus is not Chinese made. It just happened to have started in China. And quite frankly, it could have started anywhere for a variety of reasons that I'm not gonna go into. But we need to really be careful about our behavior towards people of different ethnocultural groups based on one incident. We fall into our old patterns of bias and discrimination so quickly, and we need to be very careful of that. So I would encourage you to educate yourself, to spend some time with people of Asian descent, whether they're your colleagues, your friends, your family members, and listen and hear about what's going on in their lives. Because I think we can learn a lot from that. That's it. Just a quick message. I hope you have a fantastic week. Please remember to connect with me on social media. I am at, it's been 2 weeks, at DiversityDudeMB, and CCDI is at CCDI Social. Also remember to like and share this video on your social media so that all of your friends can learn more about the wonderful world of the diversity dude, because you know they want to. They totally do. Also, if you haven't already, remember to pick up a copy of my book, Birds of All Feathers, Doing Diversity and Inclusion Right, available wherever you buy books, as long as they're selling mine. Or you can go to my website, michaelbach.com, and click on the books to find out where you can get your copy. I'm pretty sure that's it. Let's hope. Have a fantastic week. I'll see you next week for another episode of Monday Morning Musings. Bye.